Hello everyone, this is model number 105, Automatic Power Factor Compensation for Industrial Power Use to Minimize Penalty. First, we will see the hardware part of this. This is the step-down transformer, voltage regulatory circuitry, LCD display, 8051 controller IC, and this is the current sensing part, and these are the relays which are used to switch this capacitors through this UL2003 IC. This is our resistive load and this is our inductive load which is connected over here. Now I'll give the power supply and we will see the working of this. So now it has two modes, that is auto mode and manual mode. So first we will see this entire working in the manual mode. So it has compensating and lagging mode. So in lagging mode, what we are doing is we are adding only the waveform of this inductive load. Whereas in compensating mode, what we do is we add the waveform of both inductive as well as capacitive load. So again, you can see here these two switches. So here we have made use of a single switch because we have added a single choke. If you add the another load, inductive load or this choke, you can take this switch. So by sliding this switch, I can add or bypass this inductive load. So what I do is I'll just bypass this inductive load. So if I bypass this inductive load, only resistive load will come into picture. So the power factor will be 0.99, which is near to unity. So again, I'll just add this inductive load. So that time the power factor is 0.58 because this is not the pure resistive load as we have added this inductive load by sliding the switch towards this side. So now initially this is in the compensating mode. So it is like insisting us like to please measure the power lagging, please measure it into the lagging mode so we can show the improved power factor. So I have made this into lagging mode. So in lagging mode it is showing the I lag by 3.03 and the power factor is 0.58. So again I slide this into the compensating mode so we can measure both the waveform. So now I haven't added any capacitors yet. So we will see the improved power factor will be zero. So you can see here, this is the I lag which was displayed here, and this is the power factor. So as I haven't added the capacitor, it is showing improved power factor. So now as this is in the manual mode, I'll add this capacitor by pressing this switch. So when I press this switch, this capacitor will be added. So you can see that this LED is glowing, which means that this capacitor is added. So now I lag is 1.36 milliseconds and power factor is 0.91 and the improved power factor is 0.33. So here you can see when capacitor is added, the improved power factor is 0.33, which means that now when capacitor is added, the power factor is 0.91. So the previous power factor was 0.58. So 0.91 minus 0.58 is 0.33. So the improved power factor, it is showing 0.33. So we will see the waveform. So this is the waveform. 3.03 is this time difference. So initially, what has happened is the current waveform as it was at a period of 3.03 milliseconds. Now it has improved and it is showing now it has shifted to 1.36 milliseconds, which means that this current waveform has shifted. So now what I do is I add this two capacitors by pressing these two switches. So now I have pressed both the switches. So what will happen is these two capacitors will be on, which will be indicated by these two LEDs. So now you can see here, I lag is zero and the power factor is unity. So it has improved now. So the improved power factor is 0.42. So now we will see the calculation. So the power factor is 1 and the earlier power factor was 0.58. So 1 minus 0.58 is 0.42. This is the improved power factor. So now this current waveform was earlier for some 1.36. So now it is in phase. So you are getting this waveform as the I lag is it is not lagging. So the current waveform and voltage waveform are in phase. So now what I'll do is I'll add the three switches, which means that I am taking into picture these three capacitors. Wait. So now I have added all these three capacitors, which is indicated by all these three LEDs are glowing. So now I lead is 2.23 milliseconds, and now you can see here the I is leading. Now earlier it was lagging, then it came into phase, now it is leading here, and power factor is 0.76 and the improved power factor is 0.19. so you can see here this is the power factor. So 0.76 minus 0.58 is 0.19. so this is the improved power factor, you can see here. So same for this, even the fourth capacitor. So now when the current and the voltage are in phase, that will be the ideal condition. So when two capacitors were added, they were in phase, so this is the ideal condition. So now we will see here. So this, what I'll do is I'll just bypass this inductive load. So now I have bypassed this inductive load here, so only now resistive load is into the picture. So the power factor is 0.99. so now what I'll do is I'll add this capacitive load. So now the capacitive load comes into picture, not the inductive load. So this capacitor is added now. So I leads by 0.51. So now what I'll do is I'll add this both capacitor. So even now the inductor is bypassed, so these both capacitor will come into the picture. So now I leads by 2 milliseconds. It is a huge difference, and the power factor is 0.81. And so now you can see here this waveform, that is here I is leading in this picture, which means that there is a huge loss of power. So only when the inductive load is into the picture, you can add capacitive load. So you cannot add capacitive load when inductive load is not into the picture. So now we have seen the working of manual mode. So in manual mode, this LED will be on. So we will see the working of auto mode now. So this LED is on now. So initially what we have done is we have already bypassed this inductive load. So when we have bypassed this inductive load, only the resistive load is into the picture. So I lag is very less, that is something 0.38, and even the power factor is nearer to unity. So what I'll do is I add this inductive load into picture. So when I add this inductive load, so that time what will happen is there will be the current lag. So the current lag is 3.03 milliseconds and the power factor is 0.58. it has some loss. So due to this, what will happen is this capacitors will on automatically. So again I bypass this inductor. So I have bypassed this, so the current lag is very less and even the power factor is good, so this capacitors went off. So I add this into picture. So here now the capacitors are added. So this is in the lagging mode. So while giving to the controller, we will be only giving the lagging current of this inductive load. Suppose if I put this into compensating mode, what will happen is it may think that the power factor is improved. So the improved power factor will be given to this controller. So the controller may think that the power factor is improved. So what it will do is it will off the capacitor. So when it will off the capacitor, what will happen is this inductor may come into picture. So again inductor will come into picture. So it will again, to improve that, again it will on this capacitor. So this on and off of the capacitor will take place. So to avoid this, we are not putting this into compensating mode, and for the controller we are giving only the lagging current of this inductor. You can purchase this project on a website that is www.electrozil.com. So once you buy this project, you'll be getting the explanatory video of this. So in that explanatory video, you will be having like how to check the waveform on the CRO, and you can exactly get the idea how the current leads or lags. Thank you.